Now we shall discuss about high standard social science, particularly in business study. The lesson is components of business studies. Dear students, without the business, our economic activities are not happened and our nation not gradually grow. So, economic activities are business essential to development of any particular country. So in this chapter we shall learn about what are the economic activities, what is business, what is profession, how the money or value of things developed or grow stage by stage. See, that is the business process happened. In that lesson, first is introduction, next objectives and economic activities, types of economic activities, and what is exchange, and evolution and growth of commerce. How the commerce and growth and evolution from ancient till today. First of all, introduction about that lesson. Business is an economic activity. What is economic activity? The business is the economic activity. So, which is related with the continuous and regular production and distribution of goods and services for satisfying human wants. So, why the business happening and running nowadays? Because to fulfill the basic needs of human beings by production and distribution of goods and services for satisfying the human wants. So that is called the business. What are the objectives of that lesson learning? See, economic activities we can learn in that lesson. And what are the types of economic activities? What is exchange? And the evolution and growth of commerce. Role of business and commerce in economic development, large development of commerce during 21st century. So these are all the objectives we shall learn in that lesson. And we will study one by one. First of all, we shall learn about what are the economic activities. See, the term business is derived from the word music. Business is nothing but music. So music is nothing but business. So they have four relations. See, the term business, which is come from visual, thus business means being busy. So they are all busy in talking each other about the business. That's why that word comes to them, busy for the business. So all of us need, already we know that we need first of all food and then clothing and shelter. So these are the basic needs of our needs or facilities, our basic needs of all human beings. So we also have many other household requirements except these also, food, shelter and also clothing. The other demands or requirements are essential to us to be satisfied in our daily life. In the walk of life we have demanded essential except these, the another also. So these are all fulfilled by the business. We meet many of these requirements from the shopkeeper. So in our walk of life we require so many things except food, clothes, sheltering. So where we got it, where we are getting it nowadays, so we are going to meet some shopkeeper, isn't it? So the things all come to the shopkeeper. How? The shopkeeper gets these things from wholesalers. How the wholesaler gets these? The wholesaler gets from manufacturer. Okay? The shopkeeper, we meet one shopkeeper. The shopkeeper gets from the things from wholesaler. Wholesaler gets from these things from the manufacturer. So shopkeeper and wholesaler and manufacturer. So these are three persons' activities are very essential to us. These are all activities are called as economic activities. Okay. So the shopkeeper and the wholesaler and the manufacturer. So they are doing business, and therefore they are called businessmen. So those who are doing their shopkeeper work, wholesaler work, and manufacturer work, they were also called businessmen, and they are doing the work is known as economic activities. Here clearly mentioned, human beings have innumerable wants. That is not limited, unlimited wants he has. So to satisfy our wants, we need goods and services. So without the goods, we are not able to satisfy our thing. Without the service, we are not able to get the satisfied. So goods and services are very essential to reach the human being. So these are requirements or wants. So goods are produced by agriculture and industries. You know that. The primary section, agriculture; secondary sector, industry; and tertiary sector, service sector. So selling and buying goods for making profit, that is called trade. Okay. That is another word is known as business. We require many services also. So manufactured is things, but he should sell it to another one. The wholesaler get it, and immediately wholesaler sell to the shopkeeper. Shopkeeper should to the customers. Their goods and services also. This is the economic. These are the economic activities. So these goods and services are to be distributed among us. So we are all getting all these things from manufacturer through the mediator of manufacturer, wholesaler, shopkeeper. Okay. So the activities which are concerned with the production and also exchange of goods and services are called economic activities. So clearly mentioned here. What are the economic activities? Economic activities, that means which are concerned with the production. Economic activities are concerned with the production and also exchange of goods and services. So the production and exchange goods and services, these are all activities are called as economic activities. So they are all the economic activities. So what are the types of economic activities? So goods and services, manufacture, exchanging, these are all called as economic activities. Okay, over. But what are the types? See, the economic activities, they are classified into three category of activities. One is business, second one profession, next one employment. We shall learn one by one here. It is mainly concerned with the production, business. Business, it has its own, basically concerned with the production, one thing, and also exchange of goods and services. That means business is concerned to the production and also exchange goods and services, that is called business. So production here, so these productivities are also exchanged in the shop or any particular place from one person to another person to someone person, that is exchange of goods, that is called business. Production related and also exchange of goods and services related to the business. Next, profession. What is profession? Those who have skilled and tactful work and specialized technical users, they were called as the specialized or profession. See, it is mainly concerned with rendering of specialized technology. They have special technology. They have trained. So, and personal service, they have personal service. Who are the professions? See here, lawyers, doctors and chartered accountants, they are called as the professionals. Okay, businessman and professions. So second activities. Next, third one, employment. That is the economic activities of third one. What is employment? First of all, you should learn it. Employment means it is the work. Employment means it is the work which is undertaken by the people. Is undertaken by the people under an employer for salary or wages. Any person is ready to do work under anybody people for the salary or wages, that system is known as employment. per salary or wages. The employer is given the work to the particular person. So agricultural work, a laborer's employment, and industrial laborers also, they are all called employees. Employer given the work to the particular people, they were called employees. They are giver of the employment, he is known as employer. Last one, exchange. The economic activity is the third one, it is called exchange. See, the distribution of goods and services, so is called exchange. Distribution of goods and services, exchanges, that is called exchange. Distribution of goods and services is called exchange. So exchange is the connecting link between production and consumption. Somebody ready to get some things, they are called consumption or consumers. And somebody ready to produce something, they are producer. So producer and consumer, they are linked in that time. That is called activities happen exchange. So producer and consumer, they are getting things from the shopkeeper, he is supplier, distributor. So the goods produced at a particular places have to reach consumers at different places. So that is the exchange. During the course of production, the producer takes into consideration the market study. During the time of production, the producer should aware the production of their things about the into the consideration the market study, the market rate good or bad, and transportation facilities available or not, and storage capacity he had or not. Goods. Yes. See, the producer must have aware of the production of the things. That means he should know about market rate study. And also facilities of transportation are available or not. And storage of goods facility are available or not. And determination of prices about the production of the goods and advertisement. So these are all the subject matter of production of the things must have the awareness as the producer, he will be successful producer, otherwise he is faced so many failure problems. So all these aspects are included in the process of exchange. What were the process of exchange points available are included the process of exchange. So many factors are included in the process of exchange. So these are all the market study, transportation, storage of goods, and determination of price, last one, advertising. These are all aspects included in the process of exchange. Next, the evolution and growth of commerce. How the commerce, that means business or economic activities, grow stage by stage. So this is the important factors for the economic development and economic activities. So students, please take care about that question. May ask in your examination, what are the stages of evolution and the growth of commerce? May ask question in your examination. So primary stage, secondary stage, and everyone stage, how the economic activities are commerce growth. You shall learn one by one. So this the evolution and growth of commerce, it concerns production, business, industries, banking, insurance, agency, see, and advertisement, transportation, and other factors that facilitate exchange of goods and services to the consumers. So these are all the factors include the evolution of growth and commerce. The evolution of commerce has crossed over several stages to achieve today's position. The important stages are mentioned in that lesson. Let us see and observe and learn. The part one stage, the nothing but it is called barter system stage. And next stage, economic activity, money economic stage, come to the money. Next, town economic stage. Next, international trade stage. So, step by step, growth of commerce and development. First one, hunting and fishing stage. What were the features of this stages? See, in that stage, the earlier stage of human civilization, the human beings are ancient civilization people. They are not wearing clothes, full body covering, and their activities, their work only concerned to hunting and animals and fishing, catching for their food purposes only. So, earlier stage of human civilization, that is growth and development of commerce, first stage. During this stage, man was a vendor. Vendor that means travel from place to another place for searching food. Okay. So there was no fixed place for him. They are going to some place catching and collecting food from through their hunting and other ways, and leave it at that place and next go to the another places. Okay. And he moved in group from one place to another in search of food. That means they changed their place from one place to another place for searching food. They hunted animals for food. Hunted some animals for their food, and prepared themselves the weapons of hunting. And fishing was also carried out by them. Fishing stage. See, they gathered fruits, roots, and nuts for food. So they are collecting. These are some places. Okay. They lived in caves or hollows of trees. They are living some particular place, but these are known as some under the trees. See, trees under, and some hollows of trees and caves. See, so they covered their bodies with leaves. Our skins are the animals to protect their bodies from the sun, wind and rain. Now we are wearing cloth, but they are not wearing cloth. They are wearing as the form of nowadays cloth. They are leaves and skins of the animals hunting and protect their bodies from the sun and wind and some rains. So their protection of things are only hunting skins and leaves, and lived in caves and some hollows of trees. No economic activity existed during this stage. That means hunting and fishing stage, the development of commerce and commerce, development and growth of commerce, the hunting stage, there is no economic activities. Only happened activities for their own getting food service. Next, second stage, that is known as pastoral stage. Dear friends, in that stage, people learn domestication of animals. But in the beginning of the barter stage, or hunting and fishing stage, they were not domestication of any animals or anything else. But in that stage, they are ready to start the domestication of some animals. And in the beginning, cattle and sheep and goats were reared in that stage. These animals provided food to eat and skin to cover their bodies. So they are used animals for food and cover their bodies. So these are all users in that stages. Okay. Next we shall learn the critical part of next stage, next class. Thank you.